Okay, this is where it starts. This is the water source, and this is the little Y adapter I was telling you about, and timer. Actually, replacing this, this one's proved more than once to be unreliable, and I ordered a new one, a different brand, and I've heard others complain about these too, these orbit timers. So I'm going to replace this, but that's what I've got on there now. This is the backflow preventer, filter, and pressure reducer. This is a perma-loc fitting that connects the pressure reducer to the half-inch line. And I've got this going into this bypass assembly for my drip system. This bypass assembly came with a pressure regulator, another filter, and you can see where you could turn these off and change throughout the water to bypass this if you need to. But for now, it comes up through here, goes into the fert injector. This is the feed tube from my reservoir. It pulls nutrients up, injects that into the stream. This is another perma-loc fitting connected to my half-inch line. And that goes over here. This is a perma-loc T-fitting. So that's my first row. And then I've got another line that goes over here to a perma-loc elbow. And that's my other row. And you can see how I've got my quarter inch lines attached. That's the barbed T. And this is one line connected to another barbed T. And to that I've got two smaller lines, each going to an emitter. See the other one there? This is just a shutoff valve. It's another perma-loc fitting. So if I want, like when I was setting this up, I didn't do both rows at the same time. This allowed me to turn water off until I was ready to hook these up. So it's good to have these if you need them. So I've got room on the end of my lines to do one more pair. This is a terminating cap. It's another perma-loc fitting. So what I'm going to do is get my stuff and I'm going to install basically one of these on here and show you exactly how that looks. This is quarter inch poly tubing and these are my drip emitters. The poly tubing actually connect here and the water stuff comes out there. So these are the barbed T connectors I was telling you about. This one goes into the main line and then the poly tubing connects on either side. I recommend wearing gloves because it really hurts your fingers. And this is a punch tool. Punches a hole in the main line so the barbed connector can connect to. Other thing I recommend is a little tubing cutter. Makes it so much easier. Really works with a quarter inch tubing. I like to keep a piece of tape covering this so no dirt gets up in there until I'm ready to use it. And also I have a tape measure. So I'm first going to measure out two 24 inch pieces and four 12 inch pieces. And that'll give me enough to hook up this end and I'll have to do this all over again on the other side. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'll be right back. See, that makes it a lot easier. It's actually easier to do this type of stuff inside and just to do a whole bunch of them at once. Oh, another thing, just a tip, when you're laying out your main line, it's good to keep the printed side up. And that way you can kind of use that as a guide where to put your holes. And that way you know they're all kind of along the same side. There's my little punch tool. This is a really cheap one, but it works. Pretty much put it right here on the end. go. And that. That just pops right down in there. You kind of hear it click. I'll rotate around. And I've got, this is one of my 24 inch lines. Let's take that. See how that just pushes on like that? Same thing with the other one. So I need to put the T on each end. Yeah, this actually is way easier to do inside. It'll hurt your back bending out like this. But that just fits in there. And I've got 12 inch lines. And again, this is just how I'm doing mine. You could do just one line per plant. So there's that. And Nick, I just put the drip emitters. And that's that. And I want to put some tape on the ends of these so I don't get dirt in them, and get the other one done, and then I'm going to get my bag filled up and ready to go. And it'll look just like these when they're installed. Let's see how that goes. Yeah, when I get it installed, I'll turn the drip system on, just let you see how it sounds and looks. But let me get these others done, and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm going to turn this on manually just to show how the emitters work. Okay, so just open the valve to allow the water to go through. The clicking sound is the fert injector. This is a diaphragm pump, so that's the injector pumping nutrients into the stream. So we can take a look at. Sometimes these don't look like they're working, but they're actually working. They're just kind of running down the stake. And this should run for 15 minutes. But yesterday I was using it and it didn't turn off. And 2 hours later I realized this was still running. That's why I'm replacing it. It's really wasteful. And these are some sugar rush peach. These are the plants that we just installed. It's yellow dystopia. And this is a Mayan. It's got a little bit of sunburn, but the new growth looks fine. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. Hope you found that helpful. And please like, comment, subscribe, and share. Thanks.